for me, it's so beautiful thing. And it's not just a dangerous symbols. No, this is so beautiful, fragile.
So it's an absolute pleasure to have you take part as part of Choreographer's Cut. The work over the many, more than three decades that you've shared across the globe has inspired many choreographers that are established household names, and you are an inspiration for those artists. And it's absolutely great pleasure to be here with you to have Choreographer's Cut. Thank you.
It's so great opportunity, and I meet you again, and it has a great honor to be here with you.
Well, but this is about you, so we're going to talk about your work, Glass Tooth.
Uh-huh.
Yes, and the work was made in 2006.
I think you're right. I forgot everything about years.
Do you want to tell us how that work came to be?
Yeah. Material I will work with, for instance, glass or steel, iron, or books or shoes. You know, I dance with this kind of materials around me or under my feet. And this is another context of my creation, how I create things, you know, how I communicate with objects or stories or sound or music, of course, dancers, mm-hmm. or any environment. So the objects was broken glasses. Such an important thing is, for me, it's so beautiful thing. And it's not just the dangerous symbols. No, this is so beautiful, fragile. For me, this is kind of not symbol as an object. This is melting stuff for me.
Mm-hmm.
Melting is broken glasses. Was not broken before, but before the plate of glass, there was maybe stone in the ground,
yep.
you know, in earth. And then people dig it out and industrialized to be transformed to be a thin or thick plate, you know? And this is a great culture evolutional object to make a window, mm-hmm. to have a light from the outside to the into the house, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So this is kind of object of light.
Yeah.
So what is or transforming process of transforming is life. Yeah. So broken glasses is life for me at that moment. So I was dancing on a life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. This is my way of thinking of with or for materials.
Yeah.
So, but for the performance, performing arts, I don't need to speak so much about the reason why I need to, yeah. I use or I dance on there. So, for instance, filmmaker mm-hmm. Michelangelo Antonioni, he said, I don't express anything. I do this, yeah. this, yeah. this. And there is no nothing to do or nothing to show, kind of. But he showed, of course, yeah, many things.
Yeah.
But this is kind of process or process of transforming from starting point. Or if you say start, if you walk, open a door, start to walk mm-hmm. outside, and then travel, and then jump or stop and walk oh, yeah. or turn or something, and you go back to the home, something
yeah.
like. And then, so when I choose situation, I use the broken glasses. My decision was mm-hmm. broken glasses. And then I stop, step on, and start. The thing starts
when you step. Yeah.
Yeah. And then I play with the broken glasses, with the sound and the quality and the slippy or, you know, and then it reflects, those actions reflects the many sounds or many objects, objectively or subjectively, psychologically.
Yeah.
And then if it is so interesting to create many reflections with the light as well.
Yeah, which comes, I think that comes with the clips that we're going to watch. There's a yeah, central bit which we're going to get to.
Yes,
but the beginning bit, which we're going to watch now, which is where you step onto the stage from stage right. Yes, can we have a look at that bit?
If I speak about writing, this is not the sentence.
This is
they
a sentence,
are not the sentences of movement.
Mm-hmm.
They're so one word under one word.
Mm-hmm.
So under one word reflects another word, and then it gives the chance to imagine anything, something else.
So, sorry, is that like a conversation?
Exactly, exactly.
Right. Yeah.
This is a kind of duet with the muse, with the glass. Sound of glass or energy of glass.
Yeah. But one, as we watch this clip, the question that comes to mind is that it's never twice the same when you do it, or is it choreographically structured that way that whenever you step, you're going for that same sentence?
Different sentences, different words, and there's no repeating. When I turn back to my original starting point of to make a piece, this piece,
mm-hmm.
I felt I needed to break the glass, mm-hmm. and then things start starting.
Was that something in something that you were reflecting on outside of the work, or was that?
No, this is like an opening eye, right. And then make a sound of your voice,
mm-hmm.
not like that, maybe have a meaning or a purpose, a word to pronounce, and then we can start to communicate.
Yeah.
So, like this talk,
yeah.
My way of start to construct the piece is very minimalistic.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Little by little, small and small, and then a sigh and a fingertip and hesitate,
mm-hmm.
another hesitation, give me this small, tiny development.
Yeah, to go forward.
Yeah. To make forward, bigger or far away, you know?
Shall we watch
that? My movement on the moment was reflective actions from the broken glasses, sound or quality or timings from inside of the body. It's not a choreographic movement at all, but it is a kind of harmony with the broken glasses sound as well.
I definitely feel that because it was the memory of going back or trying to find that moment. No, Sam, you also, I mean, as well as being a choreographer, you're also a writer. You also design the set and also do the light and the sound. So this idea of having that tangible experience,
mm-hmm.
does that feed into the process?
So good thing you say now. I'm lighting design, yeah. costume design, set design, yeah. choreographic, and then, total decision, I mean, direction.
Yeah.
Sometimes I compose music as well. Yeah. And then I have many personalities, not character, personality, different people yeah. in my side. Mm-hmm. And then, but they're not confusing each other. They are so independent.
Right.
So they have strong conflict sometimes and a good argument yeah. as well. Mm-hmm. And then but it means they have a very contradictory relationship mm. among inside of me.
Yeah.
So I need to have a certain general person, I mean a director,
to put
those yeah, yeah. put together.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So my concept is sometimes it's difficult to understand, maybe for you or others. It's not
no,
a,
it's not.
it's not yeah. a ordinary thinking, mm-hmm. maybe. But for to unite, to get this nice relationship all together from inside me, individual mm. sections of peoples, and then I need to combine those ideas together and make a good relationship,
yeah.
communicate mm-hmm. myself.
Yeah, because there is the anchor of you that brings it
yeah.
together.
Or a general idea, I mean. Yeah. So this is a kind of very interesting game, very complicated, but it's going to be nice, need to be a very simple mm-hmm. as a result, or as a presentation or representation.
What? Yeah.
Yeah. Other piece, so people will see.
Yeah.
My story, my talk, telling the process of truth of mine, is not easy to understand, maybe, but I needed to say or need to think, remind things what I or we inside of me
yeah.
mm-hmm. Had experienced before. And then it is certain time, or hours, or months, or mm-hmm. years. No? Yeah. And then this is a very important factor, reason to build up the constructive rehearsals or constructions of structure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the section that we're going to look at is when there's a structure, actually, talking about that with the three performers. So what has shifted from the beginning of where you go from stage right to here?
That has no reason.
Yeah.
The one scene to the another, just mm-hmm. jump.
Right.
Yeah. So there is, for this relationship, there is no logic, but the visionary, or maybe if I explain myself with my
thinking, yeah.
Oh, remember, yeah. I think. This is the kind of inside and outside of the game.
All right, yeah.
Yeah, so as a body, I I said, you understand well, inside the body or outside the body, or object and objective or subjective, mm-hmm. object and abstract or something. And then the other space, I put the scene, make a scene in and out mm-hmm. with a frame of lighting or object, or without light and with the light on the glass
yep.
area. So, and then for the different materials or different context or scenery, yeah. I exchange the scene, exchange from one scene to the another. I mean, right. I, mean I construct the sequences with the different level of matter or think feeling as well.
So in that section, you continuously move through that, and then there's another performer that joins you on there. So, and there's a contrast in the movement language. What, yeah, how did that come about?
I think I really want to make, remember, rhythm of the, like a breathing, inhale or exhale. Mm. So, like that. So, other scenery, other vision as well, in and out,
yeah.
off and on. So, but it's not easy, and it's not as simple as a constant rhythms.
Yeah.
It's this rather random or different fuse, different phase of the, a different type of transforming
yeah.
or curve rhythms,
mm-hmm.
not attacking,
yeah.
not like that, more curve
yeah.
or melting rhythms.
Mm-hmm.
So breathing is such a great thing to have such a curve or melting rhythm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So because in and in, inhale, you breathe in and in and in, and then finally you cannot breathe in anymore and start to breathe out.
Yeah.
We have a workshop.
Which is a very, this is what the style
yeah.
that you've...
So breathing was my basic element of yeah. my method. That method or living method anyway.
Yeah. And actually in that duo, in that moment, you have, is it Ryoko there?
Ryoko.
In white?
Yeah.
Yes, and then that's the continuous, and actually I was watching that part, it felt that the breath idea was going through that
yeah.
while you were that in the constant, is that,
yes.
yeah.
She had her own sense or way of dancing or physicality difference.
Yeah.
So I prefer to have someone who has different things.
So, and then that shifts into stepping off the glass, and then this idea of feeling, actually there was one moment where you do drop, you crumble, and for me that really feeds into the idea of, well, not an idea, your practice and the breathing.
Yeah,
the air and then crumbling from the head and that drop. That moment that you said, that fragility, I mean, that was really vulnerable. How does that?
So I want, when I step on a glass, and then a broken glass, and then steps and turns or slides yeah. or, and then I started to make myself, my body, to melt with glass, broken glass.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to be the same material,
right.
materialized, mm-hmm. Life or something, or mover or object. I am life, and then also I am the object, yeah. one living object.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then I want to be with, how can I say, difficult to explain about. I want to be a broken glass.
Yeah, you want to be at one with the material.
Yeah, yeah,
yes.
yeah, yeah. together.
Yeah.
Or no difference, no border
yeah.
with
yeah.
glass. After that, I step out from the area of broken glass,
mm-hmm.
and then it's so radical moment. Rather than the moment I step on the broken glass the first time,
yep.
experience with the broken glass, steps and dancing on there on the broken glass area, and then I step out to the normal dance
yep.
mat,
yep.
Normal stage, very flat.
Yep.
And then it was so shocking feeling.
For you, yeah.
yeah.
For you, yeah, yeah.
And then, this is a normal or not?
Yeah.
After experience of on a broken glass, this is abnormal.
Yeah.
So this is too much controlled. Too much means, as I told you, too much or less.
Yeah.
More or less. It's so different up to you.
It's the different opposites. Yeah.
And then I felt my body so heavy. And then I have a different sense of quality of breathing after the experience on the glass.
Yeah.
And then I started to have a voice and a breath is directly from the body, every part of the body, not throat or language or meanings.
But it comes from
exactly.
That. Yeah.
So for me, this is so dramatic, radical moment to breath strongly. And then also body, it's so, how can I say?
It's like shedding or letting?
Body is so, it's so useless.
So I
felt I don't need to dance, something like that. I don't need to control my body.
So it's come through the voice.
Yeah. So my microphone was in my mouth.
Mm-hmm.
I had experienced before with a microphone in my mouth, old piece, rather than this one.
Mm-hmm.
And then I scream breath in the body, in the mouth.
Yeah.
So I want to hear the sound of breathing myself before it
makes any words.
Yeah, words, right. Or before the resonance of the air.
All right. Yeah.
So inside.
Ah.
Yeah.
So,
and then some sound inside.
So the intention actually was not to make audible
sound.
This is an
experiment.
All right.
So I didn't know. I have no expectation of what it, I don't know what is going on. I cannot understand. I cannot know imagination or no idea about. But I did it.
Mm-hmm.
And then interesting thing is there is too much. I feel there is too much. Something I didn't like or I don't need.
Mm-hmm.
The sound is too much.
Yeah.
It's not beautiful at all. Beautiful means that not this is there. It has or the voices has no balance for me.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, dislike.
All right. In comparison to the glass or not?
When you speak, you try to be. I try to make good voice
with
a nice resonance.
Yeah.
Especially you.
I'm trying to.
Anyway, so in my voice, unexpectedly, I make a dislike or a strange sound.
But that's the intention, though, isn't it?
Yes, gradually intentional.
All right, yeah.
Gradually developing.
Yep.
And I try to make a fake as
yep.
well.
Yeah.
And make it idiotic, I mean, stupid.
Yeah.
No? Nuts. And those sounds make my body strangely
yeah.
or cheap, ugly could be. It means out of control, but on purpose it is fake, liar. So something like those unsophisticated actions and substance.
Yeah.
Or it means performing.
Well, it's just to say, it's sophisticatedly understood. So you can see it because you do feel that playfulness in there as well.
So I want to. So I found myself. This is liar.
Mm-hmm.
But liar. But if I say liar, it's true. It's honest speaking, kind of.
Yeah.
No, so it sounds truth.
Yeah, which you've mentioned.
Yeah,
previously.
But yeah. I don't like either as well.
But it's very,
like a contradiction. Yeah. But it's gonna be a fake.
Yeah.
The life, this is a life, I think.
Yeah.
To make a nice contradiction, and then by the nice contradiction, you can live better, maybe.
Yes. It's true, it's true. You can do that. It's true.
Yeah. Funny thing is, when you live honestly, you feel depressing.
It's hard.
Hard.
It's hard work.
But so you need to be a nice liar for yourself or family, but it's not a success all the time.
Yeah, there's ups and downs. Yeah, there's ups and downs.
No, such
there.
A game.
Yeah.
Such an interesting thing. So, but on stage, I want to play with this one. Mm. It means it's not a planning. It was it wasn't planned. I felt I react myself like a broken glasses,
mm-hmm.
broken glass actions, reactions.
Right. Yeah.
Or I react to them, something, this kind of strange contact,
again.
You know?
Yeah.
And this is another way of actional reflection,
mm-hmm.
and the sound as well, voice.
Right, yeah.
On the other side of the game, Ryoko put the, have a broken glass, nicely,
yeah,
and a very fragile contact, and a beautiful sigh or breathing,
mm-hmm.
very nice as well. But that was happened in a natural feeling from her.
Hmm.
Yeah, this
and,
is it.
Yeah, and you get that sense when she's holding it on the edge.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that
if you contact yeah. with the broken glass, contact means grab. And she started to play with that,
mm-hmm.
just like water,
yeah.
nice water.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, this is her way.
Mm. Now you say it, I can clearly see that now, actually.
Yeah,
yeah, you can really feel that, yeah, the water. Yeah.
I was that.
Yeah.
I was there, and I was that mover or
yeah.
performer.
Yeah.
This is very honest, actually.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't pretend at all. Just did it, and then she was the same. She
yeah.
was very natural. So and then this is a certain scene.
Yeah.
For me, I like this moment very much. I don't know how good or how much that the value of the value of action or performing in performing art. I don't know, but sometimes I put this kind of scene.
Moment.
Yeah, moments.
And actually this leads us beautifully into the last section where we have the strings, and it's just, it feels that the whole journey has come to the
mm-hmm.
beginning.
I was almost stopped, still stand, just stand still, and a slow develop from the one breath to the another, and then gradually construct the movement and melting and developing bit by bit, breath by breath, and I'm going to be output outside of the body.
So
this is a kind of stream kind of, or evaporate kind of energy of dance. But anyway, so this scene. This video clip, there is, it has no scene, still scene, but it's already developed. And then, as a movement or choreographic movement, still I have struggles with the control or without, or maybe too much or less with the music.
Yeah, so that whole section, I think for me, really encapsulates the emptying of the body and the breath and this whole idea of crumbling. And that comes back to that.
So that is, so the title, Grass Tooth, this is a kind of the word I remember well about when I bite grass, broke grass.
You
yeah.
You bit.
Yes.
All right.
This is it.
This is, right. When did that happen? Did you do that before?
Yeah, during I play with the broken glass, the object, in many ways, many types, many times before.
Right.
Before this piece.
Right.
And then maybe I bite the broken glass. You bite many things, I think.
Yeah, you just pick.
Yeah, corner of a table or paper or.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the tooth of lips of actually mouth is a great contact with the quality or taste or of course texture. Yep. I like biting.
Thank you, Saburo. I just want to say it's been absolute pleasure. And I mean, we presented, Dance Umbrella presented your work, I think numerous of times, but in 2000, your work was presented, Absolute Zero was also presented along with other choreographers who are inspired by your work, like Akram Khan and Wayne McGregor. And that shows how much of an icon you are as a choreographer and what you've given the dance world. And I think for me personally, it's so important as a choreographer and master of his craft that you've really shifted the practice that's really beyond the Western context as well, and to bring that back. So that dialogue, and it's really beautiful to see that. And I think it's an honor that Wayne nominated you and the board of the Venice Dance Biennale has given you the Golden Lion Lifetime Achievement Award. And is solely so deserved, and I've known you over 20 years, and if there's, you're one of those that definitely deserve that. So thank you for all your work that you've done in inspiring many generations.
Many generations.
many generations. Thank you. Thank you,
Saburo. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.